Hey guys, good evening and welcome to my exciting channel. We're discussing Mandela effects and the like. Thanks for joining me today as we uncover the mysteries of the Mandela effect itself and find out the true meaning of it all. We must discover what is really happening, what is really going on here to change these things that we know and hold dear to us. And let us help others discover the meaning of the Mandela effect and how it affects them and the price of milk. Thank you. And be sure to hit the like and subscribe down below. Hey guys, what is up? I hope you're all having a wonderful Mandela Effect day. Hope everything's going all right for you. And I want to talk to you about this picture or portrait of Dorian Gray. You guys remember the book, The Portrait of Dorian Gray? If you're with me on this, go ahead and thumb up that video for me, okay? This is a voting video. This is going to be 566, by the way. I've already made 677 videos, folks. This is my 677th video. I will go ahead and give you guys residue sent for me. Teresa Lynch sent it to me, I mean. So, and I have to give some hats off to some other people too, because they found this Mandela effect. I'm a little bit behind on some Mandela effects, and I apologize. I'm trying the best I can here to roll steam ahead. But yeah, let me go ahead and present this. Okay, so anyway, when you go to Google and you do a quick search for the portrait of Dorian Gray, again, it's spelled G-R-A-Y, not to be confused with 50 Shades of Gray with an E-Y. So you're going to see the picture of Dorian Gray pop up, which I find this really bizarre because I remember they made a remake of this movie. I've seen plays about it. It was The Portrait of Dorian Gray, right? And this guy looks a little bit pissed. He's upset. Watch this little clip here. This guy read this book in high school, and he's upset like I am.
I read this book in high school, people, and I thought it's so weird because of the title. This is one of, I guess, my favorite villains, I guess, if you can say, is Dorian Gray. It's a guy who sells his soul to the devil so he can stay beautiful forever. I mean, what guy would not want that? Anyway, the book that I read in high school was called The Portrait of Dorian Gray. There was a movie later on called The Picture of Dorian Gray, which was in the 80s, which started The Portrait of Dorian Gray was weird to me because it's a portrait. And I thought, oh my god, that is so British. I thought it was a portrait. The Portrait of Dorian Gray. I distinctly remember thinking, Dorian Gray and The Portrait of Dorian Gray. The Picture of Dorian Gray was the movie. The Portrait of the Girl, Dorian Gray, with the book. And I was like, okay, I don't want to get them mixed up. The Picture of Dorian Gray was with the woman.
Interesting.
And The Portrait of Dorian
Gray. Okay, so apparently they made the movie in the 80s, okay, and it was the picture of Dorian Gray, but the book was the portrait of Dorian Gray. Interesting. So, this was published. Hats off, by the way, to Montre Bible. If you want, you can subscribe to him. I did. Published on April 14th, 2016. Okay? A lot of these Mandela effects are just being discovered now, though. Olivia Lilly on Facebook says, 9 tickets left for opening weekend. Dorian Gray opens next week. Get your tickets today. Look what it says. The Portrait of Dorian Gray by Olivia Lilly and the Ensemble, directed by Olivia Lilly. Tiffany McLemore was watching The Portrait of Dorian Gray, 1945 movie. The Portrait of Dorian Gray, 1945. Awesome. See? Let's see. Peter Wilde. And by the way, the book was written by Oscar Wilde with an E, okay, at the end. And this guy's name is Peter Wilde. You would think he would know this book because that's like his kinfolk, you know what I mean? So, closing night of The Portrait of Dorian Gray, Oh Mama God, what a stellar cast and creative, what a pleasure. I am totally gonna cry tonight. See? And look at that. All of these people are misremembering the movie, apparently, and the book. The Portrait of Dorian Gray, come on, it's not the picture, it's the Portrait of Dorian Gray. I remember it too. Look, this person, July 24th, posts The Portrait of Dorian Gray, Oscar Wilde. Let's see. I'm trying to bring up the picture. Okay. Anyone see a before after of American Prez? It's like The Portrait of Dorian Gray. The Portrait of Dorian Gray. Who remembers when it was called The Portrait of Dorian Gray? That was, somebody noticed it also on July 14th. You go to Amazon and it's the picture of Dorian Gray. Oh wait, what? Wow, this is crazy. Okay, it says here, The Portrait of Dorian Gray was first published in 1890 by Oscar Wilde. It's seen as one of the first Gothic horror fiction stories, and it was criticized as scandalous and immoral. This is the Special Reader's Choice Edition, which has been carefully designed for Dorian Gray and Oscar Wilde fans. Look at this. Okay, the classic book is about a young man named Dorian Gray. He is the subject of a painting by artist Basil Hallward, who thinks he's very good looking with pure beauty. Sorry. One thing leads to another, and Dorian embraces a new hedonism with Basil and a group of friends. He begins to believe that the only things worth pursuing in life are beauty and fulfillment of the senses and pleasures of the flesh. This is an excellent book. See, right here it says, "Portrait of Dorian Gray, Oscar Wilde." What? Right? It says portrait right there. This might be some residue. Look at that. That's insane. Residue right here. Oh my God. And but right here it says, it's weird how it says the picture of Dorian Gray. So did they change the name? Is it a Mandela? That's what I'm wondering. A portrait of Dorian Gray, the picture of Dorian Gray. What? See, I don't understand. Did he change it in the middle? The picture of Dorian Gray? That's what I'm trying to figure out here. Look what it says. A Portrait of Dorian Gray paperback, right? By Oscar Wilde, but in on the cover it says The Picture of Dorian Gray. That is so bizarre, guys. All right. So here's another one. This is a clip, Great Books from Europe, right? This is by Books and Pieces. Maybe we should have her come on and talk one time. Check this out.
Hello, lovely humans. As I'm filming this, it's June the 23rd, 2016, which means it's the day that the UK is going to the European referendum to decide whether we wish to continue to be part of the European Union. Now, I'm really hoping that
this
we
was published on June 23rd, 2016.
To go and vote. But before I do, I wanted to share a few pics of great books that the Earth and we go
see if
to
she talks about it.
therapist Kali Royanyemi, Paul Tiling, and
Quantum Thief.
In the history of science fiction, some universal robotic them now into a dream team of gothic wonderment.
Wow, look at that. Hang on. She's holding the book right there.
I could not decide between them, and that is Oscar Wilde and Bram Stoker. These guys are a duo of gothic wonderment. Dracula is the big daddy of vampire stories. You know the drill. Don't go out in Transylvania.
Watch her read the cover of this one.
And the portrait of Dorian Gray, that story of narcissism. And the portrait of Dorian Gray stories. You know the drill. Don't go out in Transylvania after dark. And the portrait of Dorian Gray, that...
Okay. You guys see, she is holding this book, Oscar Wilde. The picture of Dorian Gray is what it says. Oh my God, I got a chill. Oh my God. Man, that is Residue right there. This is a book queen. She knows these books. She is holding two books in her hand, and the one on her left side, her left, says Oscar Wilde, the picture of Dorian Gray, and she says portrait. Bingo. And she even posts it down here in her books mentioned, right? When you go to click on this link, it takes you here. When she mentions it, let me just say, right here it says The Portrait of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde. When you click on that, it says The Picture of Dorian Gray. That is so bizarre, guys. They're tricking us with these demon tricks. I'm telling you. I have to do another hats off to Scott Roloff. The Portrait of Dorian Gray, is it a picture? This is back November 25th, 2016, okay? Mandela Effect. He posts a video about it, which I'll play that for you shortly. And he brings up Residue from The 7-Year Itch. The 7-Year Itch is a 1955 movie starring guess who? Guess who? Marilyn Monroe. And Marilyn Monroe, we all know, is a Mandela Effect because her beauty mark shifted from here to here, the outside of her cheek, okay? Or the outside of her mouth line. So, I'm going to share with you some clips, all right? But that's all for now. Be right back.
Look at those bloodshot eyes. Look at that face. Ravaged, dissipated, evil. One of these mornings you're going to look in the mirror and that's all, brother. The portrait of Dorian Gray.
Well, there you have it, folks. He said The Portrait of Dorian Gray.
Well, suit yourself, General. Oh, but one other thing while you're here. I've been thinking about that fall list. I came up with a notion. What would you think about a 25-cent reprint of The Portrait of Dorian Gray?
The Portrait of Dorian Gray. There you go. And it's in italics. So you know that's a real thing. It's a real movie.
Hey, The Portrait of Dorian Gray?
It's a natural, Sherman. Look what we'd be giving them for a quarter. Vice, lust, and corruption. The story of a young man, unsurfaced, clear-eyed and healthy, just like you, Sherman. But underneath, dry rot, and the termites of sin and depravity, gnawing at his soul. Well, how's that strike you, Sherman?
Sounds just like him, doesn't it? All right, so I figured I'd share that with you guys. Thanks for checking me out. Have a great Mandelific day. God bless. And when you click on that link from Scott, this is where it'll take you. Esoteric Detective. And I'm going to let him explain this because he'll probably do a better job than me, okay? I'm going to let him talk about this. And by the way, if you're new, go ahead and hit subscribe if you like him, okay?
You know, I heard a story fairly recently about an event that happened in an art gallery. And somebody went up to the people in the art gallery and said, hey, what do you think of the idea this is really called, the famous story, The Picture of Dorian Gray? And they laughed hysterically. They were like, no. It's The Portrait of Dorian Gray. Now, when you line this thing up, you got to remember, the idea and the story of the Dorian Gray story is about somebody that whose actions are a little bizarre, but it changes the picture in real life. Now, let's just go down the rabbit hole of the Mandela Effect theories. Let's say you're playing with either the D-Wave computer or you're playing with the CERN Large Collider in Switzerland, and you want to try to affect reality with quantum physics. Why wouldn't you use or try to affect the Portrait of Dorian Gray story? Because it kind of brings together all of the issues that the Mandela effect is really bringing out, which is, can you change reality by doing something, or can something change reality? And that seems to be what's happening. So just like with Field of Dreams, it seems that we have another proven, and I mean proven, Mandela effect, where people today who believe it's one thing are shown clearly at one time in history it was something else. It's not the picture of Dorian Gray, it is the portrait of Dorian Gray, just like I've always thought. And when I heard this first Mandela effect being, you know, kind of bandied about, that it was the, you know, allegedly called the picture of Dorian Gray, I said, what? So I'm so glad finally me and millions of other people, including you, Ed, I know, believe now we have it proven. So let's chalk one up again for proof of the Mandela effect.
It's like we're living in the Twilight Zone, folks. But anyway, thanks for checking me out. Have a great Mandela effect day. God bless.